6 with S20. And Samsung, now we get to see how deep their bag of tricks goes, because I doubt that the Tigers are going to be trying that same composition, and they may just get some bans down on some of the champions that Samsung used to build that. LeBlanc banned out by Samsung this time, taken out by the Ku Tigers in the last game.
Yeah, LeBlanc being banned out more often from the blue side these days. Just not wanting to deal with that, being left open and being forced to pick it, or, you know, having to deal with the mind games there in terms of assassin power.
Simmer
ban, very nice. Really targeting Fury's
strength. Makes sense, makes sense. Just take away the Simmer, but they still have to be worried about Samsung taking Jinx.
Yes.
Now, and trying out one of those new Jinx fast pushes that we know they have a lot of comfort with. They don't want to first pick Gragas, which means that they may want to first pick Alistar or Azir.
Or do you think that if, okay, with the Azir ban, do you think maybe they even just take the Jinx? Oh, okay, they want to take the Rek'Sai away from Ho-Jin and really force him into an even more passive role here.
I mean, Ho-Jin really hasn't been a great Rek'Sai player, but this makes him even more uncomfortable because he's going to have to go on a more farm-oriented jungler,
right,
unless he wants to try the Lee Sin. Now, the Lee Sin is better now with those Cinderhulk nerfs, and Ho-Jin has been a jungler who did excel on Lee Sin early in the spring season. There is going to be Maokai and Alistar. No need to take the Lee Sin this early when there's some of those priority picks left up. A lot of tankiness.
Yeah, much more tanky than they were last game, and that's gonna mean that Samsung, I mean, sure, pick comms can still work if you can pick out their, you know, mid and AD carry first, but it will be a little tougher, especially with the likes of Maokai and Alistar, who can just break out of other crowd control to help protect his carries. Bard is open, though. They didn't choose to ban that Bard out. They chose to just ban out some other factors there to make it more uncomfortable for Samsung. And Samsung having some debates about what else they want to prioritize. The Maokai and Alistar have been...
They may go for Hecarim here. They could take Hecarim. They could go for Kuve's Gnar again also. And wow, taking Corki would be...
Go
interesting.
The Bard. So, well, it seems like they really want to force Prey onto an AD carry who has less mobility. Of course, Lucian and Ezreal are still available. This also allows for a lot of poke coming in from Corki to set up some of those initiates and picks through Bard.
That's true. I'm curious where this Corki's going, though, because I feel like there's a plan here. Otherwise, you wouldn't pick this Corki quite so early on. And
true.
Looks like they have two choices. They could try and gank the Maokai lane and then set up perhaps a Thresh Lucian lane and play Lee Sin where they have a lot of kill pressure. Or they could try the Sejuani and really just go for late game tankiness and outscale this Corki's ability to do damage to the massive front line that Ku has. I mean, even Corki poke isn't going to do anything against Maokai, Alistar, and Sejuani in the late game.
Yeah, it's going to be pretty rough. Sejuani so will be picked up by Ho-Jin. So Ku much tankier in the front line. They really have a lot to block for Prey, and Prey won't feel the need to necessarily stay up front and do that damage early on in the fight. They can wait until the fight starts, and Prey can just start to whittle down from the back line going forward while Smeb and Ho-Jin stay alive.
So Samsung almost certainly going to lane swap this game with Bard, Corki against Lucian. They'll have a hard time in lane if they try and do the 2v2 against that before that Corki hits 6.
And so much kill pressure actually from the Alistar too, if you just get that combo onto Bard. He's so squishy early on. TF coming out again. I mean, hey, if you're going to go with the Bard, you got the Rek'Sai.
Wow, Samsung really all-inning on the early game. If they go for Lee Sin, could be the top lane Rek'Sai.
Yeah, could be.
Has been played in China recently. And Trace plays it a lot in solo queue in Korea, but that's what it's going to be. Lee Sin and TF.
All right, and now for the Tigers. Perhaps looking for a little bit more pressure in that mid lane. I mean, sure, Lulu was able to pressure the lane, but there wasn't really any other threat after the lane phase ended from Lulu. So going with Kassadin also has a little bit of mobility to boot with the Voidwalk, so Girl will be picking up the Kassadin for some lane pressure.
Yeah, very big scaling composition from the Tigers. Again, they're in a situation where if they can stay safe early, they should be okay. Samsung, not, I feel, as good of a composition this time without that Sivir. There's a little bit lacking. Their Siege is still going to be good, and they'll have even more early game pressure. But late game, this top lane Rek'Sai, while she's great with two teleports basically early on, not having a true ultimate in the late game is not the best situation to be in.
Yes.
So Samsung, this team composition really all ends on the early and mid game. They have to have a massive advantage to take it late against the Tigers comp, because otherwise they're just going to get smashed.
Yeah, there are a lot of interesting things you can do with Lee Sin and Bard too, though. If you kick someone out, and then you can just stasis every one of the enemy team with Lee Sin, keep him alive, just get that pick and then re-engage. So we'll see if this is also something that Samsung has prepared, or they're just trying to force the hand a little bit more from Ku Tiger, see if they can get another win with Bard without having to show more of their cards today, or if the Ku Tigers will go on to set number three after tying it up 1-1. I mean, there's a lot on the line for the reputation on the Tigers' side here.
And we will have to see Kuro playing very passively early, especially if there's a lane swap.
All right, well, set number two between Samsung and the Ku Tigers coming right up. Once again on Summoner's Rift. I wonder when Summoner's Valley will come out. Summoner's Mountains.
Well, the Rift in the Valley, you know, sort of the same thing.
That's true.
Especially if it's the Great Rift Valley in Africa.
Got the Summoner's Desert.
Summoner's Rift Valley.
Luna just getting some rest and free gold against Kuro.
So, in this game, they're not going to have the same luxury, the Tigers, that is, when they want to push up the mid lane. Last time, they picked that Lulu and kept Crown contained by shoving him under the turret repeatedly and making plays on the mid lane. This time, they will not have that. They don't have the same wave clear. So Crown's going to have a lot more freedom, unless the Tigers are very careful. Also, Hojin will be hard farming. We have this early jungler in the Lee Sin.
Yeah.
So the challenge here is that you can no longer really contain the TF just by pushing up the lane and showing up in mid. This time, you actually, the side lanes are going to have to play even safer than they did last time and just hold on to turrets as best you're able.
Yeah. I mean, if the ganks come in pre-6, even Alistar and Maokai will be pretty susceptible to those, so. We'll see how active Eve will be on the map. Of course, post-6, Kuro can also try to help keep Crown in check when he tries to gate into another lane. Magical Journey being used just to catch up after checking out the lane status here.
And they're actually going to go into the 2v2, so a lot of running around the map, but they are going to opt into a 2v2 matchup.
And I mean, that range from Bard, of course, a little bit of an advantage against Alistar compared to Thresh. He can go in a little bit more freely to put down some auto-attack harass. Luna seems to also have taken a lot of defense stats to make sure he doesn't get chunked down by Lucian too early. I noticed that last game, too.
Lots of armor and MR. Even so, you really have to be careful in this situation, but they're abusing the fact that Alistar only has heal at level 1 to play a little bit more aggressively. It's not going to turn around until... Oh, nice stun, actually.
Yeah, nice stun. And even level 2, like you said, I mean, because he started with the heal, it's going to be level 3, really, when the Ku Tigers have some threat in the bottom lane. Samsung also having that experience advantage, so just trying to get what advantage they can, and then Luna will probably go forth to pick up some more chimes and maybe set something up somewhere else.
Yeah, Kuvei actually did try and succeeded in taking the Wolf Camp, so Smeb in lane just a little bit faster, able to push it up under the tower. They've got to make some plays here, Chobra, in the mid game. I don't like this composition from Samsung as much as I like the last one. You saw how they struggled to close, even though they were playing the last one pretty well.
Yeah.
And it's an even more pronounced flaw in their late game, with this composition, and harder to make picks with a Corki instead of a Sivir as well. And there's so many engage tools for the Tigers that you're not going to be able to sit and siege safely even with a Corki Twisted Fate. Smev will just come in from behind with a home guard engage, and then everyone will jump on your back line. So this is going to be, I think, a very challenging game for Samsung to win. They need to just make a lot of plays early on, and they're going to try.
Yep, Eve and Luna are waiting to maybe get a gank on to Kuro, or they might even find Hojin unawares in the river. And he's going to start the Rift Scuttler.
He used the Arctic Assault.
And they're looking for, oh, he's going to Magical Journey across the wall to make sure he can get the slow onto Hojin.
The Q.
Yeah, no angle for a stun, and Fury actually getting caught out a little bit, trying to pinch in on this gank onto the jungler. Just the move speed to make sure that Hojin gets more damage done to him.
Yep, they got the Scuttler, though. Eve snacking it with the Smite. No follow-up, no really big follow-up damage onto the Sejuani, so Hojin will get out. Three in the end.
Yeah, not going to be too big of an issue.
And now level three has been hit, so Samsung has to play a bit more cautiously.
Yeah, mid lane seems to have had a bit of a scuffle themselves here, but both of them will back out. No big kill pressure between the two of them alone. Of course, Skuro does have that Ignite, but he doesn't have his level six yet.
And the laning Rek'Sai, for those of you who haven't seen it, it is quite a good pick.
Yeah, it's very
because
effective.
Of how much sustain you have. Extremely hard to gank with that Tremor Sense. A lot of escapability, virtually no downtime in lane after you hit six. You could just come back immediately, have the two teleports to work with, so you never have to use teleport to come back into lane.
Very true. So we'll see if they can really take advantage of that, especially once TF hits 6-2 to either get ganks or get Dragon or both.
Yeah, TP going to be up soon for Kuve, and you just keep pushing. So the Rek'Sai is a champion you can put a lot of turret pressure on with, just based around your opponent's recalls being more punishable than your own. But still, no big movements from Eve.
Yeah, he's been playing a little bit passive too. I mean, for one, obviously not as many opportunities presenting themselves because of the way the Ku Tigers are playing, as they should, appropriately. So just trying to at least keep up and farm. But Hojin is getting that slight edge in experience so far. Luna just doing what he can to keep Prey and Gorilla Zone. Has given Fury quite an advantage in CS for now while this wave starts to form in the bottom lane.
Eve trying to find Kuro now. Crown does have his ultimate available at this stage. Kuro opting for a Blasting Wand first, just for some extra trading power right here. Not too concerned about getting hit by the wild cards, confident that he can dodge it. Luna now coming up just for a deep ward before Magical Journeying his way.
Yeah, Kuro not going to find an angle on that. And as everyone starts at level 6, the gank opportunities are diminishing very quickly for Eve. Every lane's going to be super tough to get a kill in. They will continue to clear out wards around Dragon Pit, though, making sure they have that vision advantage. Another ward still there in the river from Gorilla.
Yeah, Luna's roaming this game. Just hasn't actually resulted in much of anything. But it does get a nice deep ward in. That's, I suppose, valuable in its own right. And the nice thing about Magical Journey is that you can play pretty risky in terms of your ward placement.
Yeah.
Because you'll be able to get back to your allies so quickly. And you're not caught in a 2v1 situation or some unfortunate ban up situation where the other team has that advantage.
So meanwhile, we saw Crown maybe looking for an angle in top lane, but the lane was starting to push up a little bit. And Smev, of course, has his ultimate. Kuro having a little trade with Crown. They even out. So Kuro is pretty happy with that. He is the one with Ignite, so if they keep having even trades, he'll be the one with a little bit more kill pressure later on if it happens again.
Crown's out of lane. MIA ping's going down for Kuro, letting his lane out. There could be a little risk right there, but nobody in danger of being ganked, and that's just going to be the blue buff handed over, not actually any movement on the map to get the gate down, but good heads-up play by the Tigers as they play super defensively for the second game in a row.
We've seen this before.
Well, it's gonna be a lot more effective this game than it was last game.
Definitely. And we saw Rek'Sai also taking that Gromp back and forth with that mobility with the tunnels. Was able to get more of an advantage as he can. And Samson going to take this quick window to try to go for the Dragon as they saw the bottom lane from the Tigers go home. And looks like they should be able to get it unless Hoshin goes for some crazy risky play for a steal here. Just going to put a ward down, back out. Doesn't want to go in, especially when everyone has their ultimates on both sides.
Yeah, takes the ward out as well before it can quite close.
Uh-oh, Luna's going to get caught. He can't Magical Journey out here. And that's a quick first blood for Prey.
Yeah, that was pretty greedy.
Yeah. I think he saw, you know, Hojin take that ward out and said, all right, well.
You have to know that that's the timing when Prey and Gorilla kind of come back into lane. You made that initial decision because you wanted to take the Dragon while the dual lane was gone. So trying to get some wards up towards their jungle when they're definitely back at that stage, not something you want to be doing.
Yeah, it did seem a little bit mistimed. They already saw Hojin, too. They knew exactly where he was.
That was a really boneheaded move by Luna. you know that one's coming. 100%.
Kuve just playing super sneaky with all these tunnels going from brush to brush.
I'm actually surprised that Kuve didn't take Smite here, that he went for the flash instead on the top lane Rek'Sai, just because the Cinderhulk Rek'Sai, pretty scary. And it also just speeds up your split push. So he instead opted for the Cowl first.
Yeah, I have to think that the Flash may be just purely because they're playing a comp around Bard. And here we go. A nice Magical Journey coming in with two members. Can he get the stun onto Gorilla? There's Unbreakable Wool. And Prey does get stunned, but he gets some nice culling damage onto Luna. Crown coming in too, but they can't get a kill. And yeah, this is what happens post-level 6. I mean, who are you really going to pick off?
Gorilla played that very well, too. Just waiting for people to come through on the Magical Journey and bouncing them up with the Pulverize right away.
It's kind of what we talked about last game, but being done towards Bard's team instead of them doing it to enemies chasing them through. Nice trade from Kuro.
Yep. And big ward still protected by Kuro right there. That's been a thorn in their side this whole game. So first TF ult not going exactly as planned, but it did blow Smeb's TP. He did cancel it on the tower, but they're going to have another opportunity with this Rek'Sai to make a TP play if they want to.
Yeah, and they do have Tempered Fate still, so they could maybe even go for a dive, especially with Gorilla's ultimate also being down. Lots of threats can be eliminated from that heavy anti-dive factor that you get when you play Alistair.
Yeah, Alistair really an important pickup here for the Tigers. It was banned by Samsung in game one. I think they realized that the Alistair foils a lot of their plans with his composition.
Right.
So letting it through in this game, which is why I was surprised they first picked the Rek'Sai.
Very true.
Instead of picking the Alistair themselves.
Eve looking for an angle on Kuro, but it is Kassadin, so he will just Rift Walk out. Hojin showing up onto a ward, but he will just stick around to make sure they don't go for any further shenanigans. And he's just going to run into Eve. He's just going to have a little bit of a trade. Trying to draw him into Kuro, but Eve's wiser than that. And Kuve being just as annoying as when Rengar was popular in top lane, but hiding in brushes and popping out.
That's how you do on top lane. And look at that too, getting the Spirit Visage for the extra healing as well. That's just incredibly annoying in terms of his sustain and ability to trade, even though Smeb did have, or does have that Catalyst already.
Yeah, I mean, the fact that he's been able to keep up, if not stay a little bit ahead in terms of the whole sustain war, especially with the teleport advantage too, against a Maokai is very impressive, because Maokai is known to have a lot of sustain with his passive. And look at all these tunnels giving him that mobility. But there is a Destiny Gate coming into Smeb. He does flash away from the gold card. There's still a flash and the kick backwards onto Smeb. They get a lot of damage with the follow through from Lee Sin, and Eve will pick up the kill there as Hojin.
Are they going to dive the bottom side or just put pressure on down here? Their ping's going down onto Hojin. They know he's there in the brush.
Yeah, I mean, Luna has the Tempered Fate, so this could also go horribly wrong for the Tigers if they don't watch out, but it looks like they're just going to back out. Luna might use that ultimate to buy themselves some time until his teammates come, using his Shrine to get some vision there in the mid, or in the brush. And, uh-oh, Kuro and Hojin both towards the mid lane now. Now, they're not seen by wards. Hojin is seen, but Kuro is not. But when you see that Sejuani there, you're going to know something's up. So Crown just backs out. Meanwhile, Rek'Sai void rushing all the way to the top.
So successful gank from Samsung, but it was at 13 minutes into this game. So that doesn't mean very much for them right now. 1,000 gold advantage. But not a whole lot else going for them. And they have to get a lot more than this. We'll see how they do when Fury gets that Trinity Force. He's getting very close right now. Should get it on this recall, and then Prey completing that Infinity Edge already. Prey, of course, usually preferring to go Ghostblade Infinity Edge on his Lucian builds. Likes to have the big cullings with the Ghostblade active to chunk out people and make the most of that poke.
Yeah, that'll be good against his team. I never am pretty squishy, so if you get a couple hits from the culling down, they won't be able to go in for the picks as easily.
Looks like Kuve might be going Black Cleaver. That is interesting.
Okay, I mean, Black Cleaver.
It's a good item on Rek'Sai for sure.
Yeah.
Going to be able to quickly stack that up with your Q.
Yeah, and Smev is just going to be forced out of it as they saw Luna and Eve towards that mid lane. And that's going to give Hojin a chance to try to go for this dragon. It looks like it will be free. Eve going to try to trade that for a red buff and that top tier 1 turret in favor of Samsung. So just some...
I like the emphasis Samsung has on gold right now first over the dragons.
Oh, and there's a gold card onto Kuro, and he's actually going to get stunned on the wall by Luna. Teleport coming in just to extend the time from the turret aggro there. So Kuve using that accurately and then canceling it so that he can just still stay up there and collect a little bit more farm. Really good communication coming in for Sansa. And there's Destiny. They're going to see Gorilla. They get a nice stun onto it, but they don't want to go in just yet. They've used a lot of their abilities for that one kill in mid lane.
Yeah, Kuve there as well. Just get some extra damage onto Smep. Not a whole lot, but Kuro really paying for that. And two towers actually traded for the dragon as Samsung just collapses on the top side of the map after Smep goes back.
Yeah, the Tigers did get that tier one in bottom, but it was pretty prime for the taking there because of that early push they had against Fury.
Yeah, and
good stun by Luna. Follow through.
Kuro just gets hit by absolutely everything right there. Nailed with the Dragon's Rage at the end. Great chaining of CC for the dive, and you have to realize that's going to happen if you pick this Kassadin in the mid lane against all these champions that can come in under the turret so easily.
Kuve is just playing cat and mouse here with Smev with all the tunnels.
And there's another outer that goes down for Samsung. So they've got all three quite quickly. This is the boost they needed in this game to make their comp relevant. But how do you siege from here? There's no more dragon for a while, so you can't force much of anything for quite some time. Do you actually dare to group up in this situation? It would be hard to siege tier twos this early.
I mean, looks like they'll really just have to take advantage of the vision they have, especially on the top side. Obviously, all the vision very clear. We do have the Cutlass coming in after the Trinity Force, so Fury really hitting a nice power spike towards the mid game here at 17 minutes. Kuve also being able to do a lot of damage now with the Phage and his own sustain against Smeb. And because he's against Rek'Sai, you know, he had to go a little bit earlier for the armor there with the Glacial Shroud, but lots of magic damage coming in elsewhere, even from Porky. So Smeb not going to be that tanky yet. So it looks like they will be grouping up top, but the Ku Tigers reading this accurately. They saw the aggression from Kuve and not going to take any chances. This is how the Tigers have been playing in the summer season. Super cautious, and Luna trying to take out that pink, but he's going to have to do Magical Journey out.
Yeah, Kuro set up a wave in the bottom side that should be slow pushing towards Samsung. So they're going to have to go back and deal with that eventually. So there is a timer on what the Samsung Galaxy team can do on the top side of the map. Kuro just slowly clearing out waves, moving between top and bottom and trying to hold that side of the map. So Tigers is turtling their best at this stage.
Yeah, Crown being sent to take care of that bottom wave while Fury and Luna show up in mid. They do need to watch out a little bit, but Eva's nearby. Now Cuvée could be open to a flank, but tons of wards in the top side for both teams, so no one should be caught unawares. Four members here in mid. Can Fury do enough clear? Looks like it. He clears out the first wave. Nice stun from Luna onto the minions to buy some time. And that's given Crown so much time to push right back up to the tier two. He's just checking to make sure they get vision of the enemy champions again. And it looks like, yeah, they're missing still some of them, especially Kuro. So Crown will just back out, regroup with his team.
Not best culling right there. Didn't save it to actually push forward the minion wave. Just got a couple of errant hits onto Corki. But this TF less threatening in the split push this time, deciding not to build the Sheen right after the Unholy Grail.
Yeah, Kuro's hiding in the jungle right now, trying to get a pick onto Crown, and they're going to run right into each other. And there's a teleport coming in from Smev. Crown looks like he'll just have to Destiny Gate, and he does get it after the stun onto Kuro. But that's a big spell used for Samsung, where they just have to use it to back out.
But that pressure really isn't relenting right now. Kuvée's going to get some damage down onto the tier 2 turret. They get the blue buff onto Kuro at least, but how much are they giving up for? It looks like about 50% of one tower's HP.
So well done by Samsung, not immediately going for the counter teleport. They're out of panic. They know what their composition is, and they can't just match the initiation with their own aggression. Just have to pick their own fights on their own terms. So Samsung playing their composition very patiently, in fact.
Well, they are, but this isn't a composition that you can really afford to play patiently. At the very least, they're getting some chip damage down on towers, but they need to make headway, actually get some of these tier twos to get that money so they can remain relevant in the late game. Crown actually going for the Zhonya's Hourglass first. I'm not sure I like this Chopra, just because the split push is really effective for them at the time being.
Right.
And they need those tier two turrets down, and we see this TF constantly on the bottom side of the map. So why not go ahead, get the split push that you need?
I wonder if he just feels a lot more threatened from Kuro's Kassadin that can come and just try to start a duel with him. Or maybe able to buy some time and use that for initiations. I mean, they do have Cuvée who can split push a lot more efficiently this time around. Just thanks to mobility. Of course, Gnar's a great split pusher, but
think about the 1-3-1 here from Samsung. You have the double teleport Rek'Sai, you have a TF down in the bottom lane, and then you have Corki, Bard, and Lee Sin. No way that they're going to be able to engage on that.
Uh-oh, no tier one here for Crown to escape to, so he's gonna have to back out, and the Koo Tigers are gonna get a nice start onto the dragon. Now Cuvée's gonna try to take down this tier two, and then he can still join up with the teleport, and there is the Tempered Fate coming in. Kuro's also been locked up. It's at 2,700 health. The teleport is here. Now Hojin gets the dragon. Gorilla goes in very deep and pushes Crown back into the enemy team. There is the Zhonya, so it's been completed. Some burst coming in from Fury, but Smet picks up one kill. Fury actually flashing forward for a kill, but he's going to get caught as Kuro jumps through for another kill. Eve's going to get knocked up by the Arctic Assault, and Cuvée has a double kill himself, but he just can't catch up to this Kassadin. Will be able to Rift walk away one more time, and now Cuvée has to escape from a tree and a Poro, and he'll be able to.
Yeah, no way they can kill Cuvée after all that went down. Luna trying to push up the mid lane and force them to lose at least some CS, get a little bit more turret damage, but the dragon goes over to Tigers, and they get that extra kill, trading 2 for 3. So that is nice for the Tigers as they start to really hit their stride in this game. Kuro going to be getting that Zhonya's Hourglass pretty soon. Finally, Prey completing a static Shiv as well. So they may have turtled out long enough to be relevant right here. There is that 4K gold advantage for Samsung. They still can compete, obviously, in the game with that kind of edge, but
yeah,
they are really running out of time.
Yeah, and Crown and Fury, Gorilla doing a really good job just keeping Crown and Fury at bay and then knocking Crown in. And Fury, of course, on that Corki has not the longest range. His escape also not the best, as you can be knocked out of it. So forcing him to get a little closer to the fight, and the Tigers being all grouped up. Now, QV did a lot of damage with that Black Cleaver last fight. I mean, he got that double kill.
Yeah, I think this is a really good item on the top lane, Rek'Sai. Look how much CDR he has as well. So he's just constantly threatening, putting up big damage with his Q.
And just making sure that Ward stays alive. Nice play, and Kuro tried to go back for one more hit, but he's not gonna get it.
Also, Kuve is the right choice to pick onto Kassadin too, because Kassadin can't Rift Walk on top of Kuve to deal damage, otherwise he gets CC'd.
Yes.
So that's a very interesting aspect of Kuve being the one to split push up against this Kassadin.
Whoa, Gorilla taking a huge burst there with the Sorcerer Shoes coming in from Fury. Kuve did a lot of damage onto this tier 2, and he doesn't really care about any damage that Smeb does to him, because he'll just be able to tunnel out. And he could ult out if he needs. So as long as Samsung holds on to their tier 1 here in mid and top, Kuve will eventually take that tier 2 and force a little bit more out from the Tiger. Smeb doing his best to keep him at bay and getting rid of all the tunnels, but they just keep coming back. And Kuve with the Black Cleaver, he's doing a lot of damage onto Smeb. Smeb is going to need to watch out.
Smeb has a frozen heart, and he's taking that much damage from this Rek'Sai. Goes to show the power of this new item, and Kuve too has so many tunnels because of all the CDR that he has.
Yeah, they're just everywhere. And there's a Tempered Fate going in for a dive, and there's a gold card onto Prey. Can they get the stun? He gets it, and Crown picks up the kill. Fury's gonna be able to get right out of tower range, and then Magical Journey out. That leaves Crown all alone after the Zonias. Doesn't look... Oh, nice stun from Luna, giving Crown time to jump through the Magical Journey. Kuve also showing up first to make sure that his team has a retreat.
Yeah, quick dive right there, but Samsung, they can't really get anything more off of this. They keep trying to push forward, but only one kill. No dragon to be taken. Kuve's just gonna go and farm out the top side. Has to deal with that minion wave. So sure, they get a kill, but it doesn't really help their lead all that much. Tempered Fate, like you said, onto the turret, immediate gold card onto Prey. Prey not with the QSS yet. And then he just gets chain CC'd forever. Fury starts taking some turret hits at the end. And they try to get on to Crown. Luna just
gonna... Oh man, what a stun.
I'm really surprised at the angles Luna's getting on some of these stuns.
It's very impressive. So, like you said, they got that kill, but not much else from it. So the gold advantage not...
Yeah, they really took nothing.
Much different.
Not even really a buff right there or anything at all. So it's not going to create the snowball that they need to maintain momentum in this game. They've got to get something more.
Yeah, and Fury also a little bit behind in experience because they've been grouped up in that mid lane for so long, finally hitting that level 13. But of course, that advantage goes in favor of Kuve, who's level 16 now in the game, and Crown 15 already. But the Ku Tigers will finally find that opening to take down the tier 1 and top. That should give Kuve all the time he needs to take out this tier 2. No teleport on Smeb. We'll see if the Ku Tigers can chain this into a tier 1 in mid at the same time. It's pretty healthy, though. So it looks like they won't be able to, especially after Kuro taking all that burst and poke.
This split pushing by Kuve has been excellent.
He's
taken
going.
So much.
Oh my gosh. I mean, who's going to stop him? I mean, Smeb's trying to go back again, but he's been stopped. No teleport. And they're just still poking out at him, and we do see a Destiny Gate onto Hojin. Crown is caught a little bit. He's going to have to be careful, but we do have Fury putting out some nice poke from the side. Luna gets caught, though, and that's going to be the end of that. Looks like Crown got a little too eager with Eve there to try to make something happen and allow Kuve to keep split pushing.
No one going back, though. Kuve is going to be starting to go for this inhibitor. They've got a tier 1 maybe for this.
I mean, at this point, Samsung can give up this tier 1. They don't mind as much if they can actually get the inhibitor, which looks like they might, because how are the Ku Tigers going to go back home? Okay, Smeb is now finally back. Kuve just wants to take this, though, at this point. It's already down to 20% health. We do have Kuro showing up now. Kuve has his ultimate, so if a push comes to shove, he can try to make that happen for himself. He's trying to wait for Voice Rail. Oh, he's actually doing a ton of damage onto Kuro, chasing him out, but eventually he will go down.
So, but they took the inhibitor out. Now Dragon for Samsung. They're already positioned on it. That was a lot to give up. Two turrets and an inhibitor for a couple of kills, a Dragon and a turret for the Tigers. They need to start pressuring this Baron if possible, but the problem is Kuvei has both TP and Void Rush up, so how do you really do that right now? They're in a position where they have to turtle even harder. Ooh, really poor trade from the Tigers. Now, Samsung did keep them around there, but the Tigers weren't decisive enough. If you want to give that up, you have to just go for Baron or something like that. Make the big, big trade. Once you pick someone off, really punish them for that decision. Because if you take the Baron right there, maybe you can get an inhibitor in response.
Right.
But just diddling around the mid lane waiting and not being so decisive about recalling and then allowing Samsung to delay your recalls really hurts you.
Yeah, and Kuvei now with a Randuin's finish, level 17. If Samsung wins this, Kuvei will be right on track to take that MVP, doing so much work for Samsung. Now, the Tigers are positioning around that Baron pit and making sure they control vision, but bottom lane's pushing up again with those super minions now.
They basically just have to do Baron here. That's the problem, and the Rek'Sai makes that even more difficult because you sort of have to fake it if you're going to do it by running around in circles. Smeb is the designated one to stop the split push, but he doesn't have TP up, so a very small window here where Samsung could take a preferable fight. But they've got...
it's back. The Banner of Command now pushing up alongside Kuvei here in the top lane. That's going to be a real bane for the Tigers. I mean, they can group up all they want and get some good fights, but if Kuvei's pushing with this minion, and Kuro can't stop this. I mean, Smeb is going to be the best at barely stopping it, but not really getting any advantage from that either. So Samsung looks like they might try to position for a Baron, or at least a pick at the Baron pit. As Gorilla just goes in safely to place that ward, it will be cleared up. Kuvei making sure he keeps track of the jungle with Tremor Sense. And Samsung's going in. Luna's positioned. Prey, Hojin, and Gorilla all a little bit separated. A nice attempt at a stun. Not going to get it, though. Try to get the slow first from the memes. There's a gold card, though. Gorilla is now at half health, so he is going to have to watch out. Kuro shows up. Kuvei takes no damage. And, I mean, the Tigers, they really want to regain more vision here, but what they do have is vision in the lower side of the jungle, so they know that Samsung hasn't completely retreated from the Baron pit.
Right, so they're at least able to keep eyes on that for the moment, even though if all the Hojin is going to face check this.
Yeah, well, he saw Luna out there, but Hojin's going to get kicked backwards. He takes a lot of damage. There's a calling, but Crown is in his Zhonya. Stasis, Prey still gets the kill as Kuvei shows up. Kuvei's going to kill. Keep on Prey, and he almost gets the kill, but he'll have to back out. Very tanky. There's still poke coming up. Cross the wall from Fury, and Eve is still alive. There's the magical journey. As Kuvei goes, he tunnels out. He gets a hit on Takuro to tell him to back off. And there's a Righteous Glory coming in, but look at the damage onto the Nexus turrets. Can they get another kill? They can. So a 2-1 kill score in favor of Kuvei. Oh, actually, they will get the dive on Fury. Fury getting
a
little too cheeky.
They have to get Baron here. But there's the Void Rush. Kuvei's coming back in. He's trying to delay it as much as possible.
That is the most annoying Rek'Sai. I mean, the Tigers can do it now safely. Eve is still alive, too. And Kuvei's just keeping them at bay, so they can't go back to clear this. Gorilla does finally come up, so they won't lose the second Nexus turret, but they already lost one. It's a lot of damage done against the base of the Ku Tigers.
And now they have to all recall, so okay, a couple of kills, but again, they fall behind in terms of objectives. Samsung just out-trading them every single time.
Yeah, starting to chip away at that top lane inhibitor turret also.
The inhib should nearly be back up, however.
Yeah, so Ku Tigers will get some breathing room, and they'll have to really abuse that timing to at least gain some control over this side of the map so that Samsung doesn't get both a Baron and the inhibitor with Rek'Sai's mobility.
Yeah, that's such a huge mistake. For a solo split pusher to get an inhibitor by themselves in this meta is ridiculously hard to do, and Ku made some really big mistakes in the mid lane to allow this situation to unfold. And even though they are catching up in gold, comparatively, they just lost entire control of the map. So inhibitor back up now. They will be able to stabilize in this game. And now their composition can kick into gear again. As long as they can control Kuvei without that turret there, he's going to be able to do a lot of work on that inhibitor and maybe take it out again.
Yeah, they really need to push it as far as possible right now so that even if Kuvei shows up again in the bottom lane, it's going to take at least some time for the waves to catch up. and then use that timing to get some advantage in the top side of the map. I mean, the Tigers have to play a very intricate game, and Kuve's mobility is really ruining that fun for them.
Well, that and Twisted Fate as well.
Yeah. Still no Lich Bane, so this time just going for that full burst now for Crown. With
yeah, I really disagree with his build this game. I think if you want a split push like we're seeing with...
Oh, Eve's going to get caught with a little damage. He will be able to safeguard away.
Because when you build the TF for the team fights like this, it's almost like what's the point against the tankiness and the late game composition that the Tigers are running. You're winning on the map because you're giving them the runaround, not because you have a death cap on your Twisted Fate.
Kuve is now in that bottom lane. He's got tunnels in the top side.
They have
no teleport.
They have to do the Baron. They have to do the Baron right now without TP from Smeb.
Yeah, so the Tigers are just going to go for it. Now, looks like Samsung might actually just choose to go for the inhibitor and try to hold it off. Now, there is Tempered Fate, too. Luna could try to make this really not worth it for the Tigers. And we're going to see it. There's the Stasis coming in. Buys a lot of time. Can Eve try to get a steal? They don't want to commit too much. Crown and Kuve might actually just go for the finish of the game. If Samsung can keep them at bay, Eve is going to sacrifice himself, and Smeb, three members will be able to port back home. You can't finish this, especially without that Lich Bane. Now we're really seeing that not pay off, and Samsung actually taking a lot of hits here as Luna trying to make an escape. They do get the second Nexus turret, and Prey might go down. He does go down, so he's going to lose that Baron buff, but they will catch Kuve eventually. So an ace for the Ku Tigers, but Samsung still getting some of what they intended.
Yeah, well, they did try and make that trade. They realized that they couldn't actually do that Baron fight with their composition, so they delayed it as long as possible with the Tempered Fate to make the trade. And now with Super Minions, there's not going to be that opportunity for the Tigers to just rush the enemy base either, because they have to deal with it or their Nexus goes down. So instead, they're going to take the fourth Dragon Stag, try and force a fifth Dragon, and hold on again with that Baron buff. And they can't leave because they'll get backdoored by TF and Rek'Sai.
That ward. That's very crafty. Leaving that ward in the enemy base as the teleport comes up. We got extra AD onto Kuve. Now, I don't think he'll be rushing for that chance just yet, but it's there if he needs it, especially, like you said, with that Twisted Fate. Looks like TF will be going for that Lich Bane here afterwards. And maybe once that completes alongside Blade of the Ruined King, Kuve and Crown will just rush in there and try to burst down the Nexus. It's a huge threat, and Ku Tigers, if they want to counter that, they have a lot to chunk through on the enemy side of the map.
Yeah, Prey trying to get into a Bloodthirster finished right here, just so he has that shield to deal with the split-pushing Thornmail threat that is Kuve. Kuve doing a lot of damage with this Black Cleaver.
Yeah, the Tigers will be able to defend their base just fine because of the Baron buff, but again, it's not the best place to be if all your Baron buff helps you do is defend.
But by the time that the next Dragon is up, there's going to be the Inhibitor back up as well. So
yes,
they got the objectives they needed. They got both Baron and Dragon. They're not in a good position. Samsung still is dictating the course of this game. And now that both Nexus turrets are down, even if the Inhib is up, like you're saying, that Lich Bane and a Blade could just end them in terms of a backdoor on the two globals. But there is still a shot for the Tigers to win here.
Definitely. But man, the way Luna's been playing that bar too, I mean, Samsung can really buy Kuve and Crown a lot of time when they want to push in, even if the Tigers are just blatantly aware of what's going on. Now, Crown is in some danger, though. He's going to get caught. He gets the stun and then tries to ghost away. He will be able to escape as Kuve shows up. And then there's the Destiny Gate back in. The Zonya's after the gold card. There's a knockup on Takuro. Now, we do have Crown flashing back out, but Kuve can 1v2 right now. There's a gold card on Takuro. Kuve tried to predict the escape path for Prey. Prey's very low. There's the Zonya's from Kuro. Now Crown's still nearby trying to do some damage. Kuve, can he get another knockup? No, but that's going to draw a lot of attention away from the Tigers, so that Samsung trying to make something happen in the top side, but they don't have enough manpower as Luna was caught out.
That game nearly ended
right there.
The Ku Tigers. If Prey and Kuro had died on that turnaround, the game is over. The Nexus is rushed, that's it. There's no more League of Legends for the Ku Tigers today. So this game has been so close.
Yeah.
And it wouldn't be a Koo Tigers game if they weren't just facing epic odds. I feel like every time we see the Koo Tigers, it's like the 300 soldiers at Thermopylae trying to hold the pass against the Persians, where... Why do we have to have this every time?
The Najin in them never left them. Well, they're fighting as best they can. The inhibitor is slowly forming back up. As you mentioned earlier, Monty, when that dragon comes up, it'll be about similar timing. And that dragon's going to be pretty big because it will be the fifth stack for the Tiger. So this, you know, Samsung can't take that too lightly unless they know they can finish the game at that point. Because with five stacks, the Tigers could, the Tigers could really force a fight and get a lot more to catch back up and put themselves on complete even grounding.
Well, like you're saying, it's just a go.
Okay, yeah, Dragon's Rage had to be used. They don't want Luna to be caught out right now. Death timers are pretty long, and while Luna is not the strongest champion with Bard, he has so much utility in terms of how Samson can finish this game. I mean, Bard alone allows for so much creativity. Inhibitor now back up 2 minutes for Baron, then about a minute after that for Dragon.
It's so funny that the Tigers have double the kills of Samsung, but Samsung's map play has just been so much better than theirs that they're holding the Tigers captive within their own base right now and just running amok on the map. Ooh, Dragon and Baron, that is really bad for the Tigers that they're going to be spawning at the same time.
Just,
of course, that happens when you take the Baron and then take the Dragon a minute later, but that's going to force a really hard decision from the Tigers because that Baron buff on the enemy will be quite potent in taking down the rest of their base.
Yeah, I mean, if push comes to shove, obviously the Baron a higher priority for the Koo Tigers. It's only the second stack for Samsung if they get the Dragon.
I don't know. That true damage and the extra 15% damage in a team
either
fight,
way, yeah.
They already have a team fight advantage, and that would turn it overwhelming. I think I'd rather have that than the Baron buff right now, because if you win that fight with all the extra damage,
here's a teleport coming in. The Koo Tigers really trying to force his flight as the two split pushes are in the same lane. Kuro does get stunned, Crown ghosting away. Smep coming in with a righteous score. He gets the slow onto Kuve. Kuve gets his own slow. There's a knockback from Gorilla, a little bit mischained from Gorilla and Smep.
Here we go, back door.
And Fury showing up. Now, Prey is there. They can't stop the port back, though. Eve there with Fury. I don't think Samsung can actually secure this inhibitor as Hojin shows up. Prey's going to do a lot of damage. There's a magical journey. Fury going to immediately
QSS. Wow.
Wow. Meanwhile, Crown is still caught. They committed a little too much to prevent the port back, and Kuve's still doing a lot of damage onto Kuro. I mean, Kuro's the main damage source out of these three.
Wow, they saved the inhibitor too, so this is absolutely huge. Kuve gonna take some percent damage from Smeb on that Twisted Advance. Trying to get this kill, it's so
he wants
dangerous.
It! But Kuro's gonna be able to Riftwalk back in, and Luna, oh wow, what a temper fate to keep Hojin at bay.
Keeps him alive, but Koo overwhelmingly wins that and outplays him on the map. That was such an impressive display of map control right there to keep everything alive and still get the fifth dragon stack, and they're probably gonna get the Baron too, and they shut down the threat because they killed both Kuve and Crown. That could not have gone better for the Tigers.
Yeah, really good decision making to note that Crown and Kuve were a little bit too far from the base to make anything happen, but both in the same lane as split pushers and just making sure they get that pick, even though they didn't get the kill immediately.
And the Baron buff, the empowered recall for the Tigers is gonna shut down the opportunity to actually backdoor. That's actually the most important thing. The rest of the Baron buff doesn't really matter. The fact that you cut your recall time in half is the kicker.
Yeah, so Samsung will have to just another 5 minutes until these buffs die out before they have a viable way of ending the game. But now the Tigers are starting to inch forward in gold. They are getting all of their items.
QSS done now on Prey as well, so he's not going to be able to be gold carded. The Tigers should be able to push to victory right now. That shouldn't be too much of an issue for them. They can just dive any turret at this stage. And again, they don't really have to worry about the back door any longer because they're going to have forward position on the map. And They may have, and the tunnels are all on the top side, so there's not really a good location. They'd have to use TP for Kuve.
Oh, Crown's being chased out by Hojin, and there's an ultimate onto Crown and the Arctic Assault. Kuro coming in. Crown does have to flash and ghost out, but meanwhile, another turret goes down in favor
of
the Tigers.
These turrets are going to fall with the five dragon stacks.
Yeah, Hojin has that Banner of Command himself, too, using Samsung's own medicine against them as they get an inhibitor here in mid. And the Tigers, they don't care about the other ones. He can just push through right now. There's a Righteous Glory from Smeb, and he's just going to go ahead, stand in the front line with Gorilla. They're just tanking all the damage coming in from Samsung. Samsung can't do anything, but they need to put up one last fight as Kuve goes in. He tries to get the pick onto Prey. Can he get him? Prey's fighting so hard for his life as Kuro also gets stunned outside of the fight. Gorilla trying to keep everyone else at bay. And there's a Tempered Fate, but Ku Tigers will finish off the Nexus.
Well, that was a very exciting game, Chobra. And the Ku Tigers had an extremely good play to dig themselves out of that hole. But that is a hole that they should have never been in the first place. Samsung did a good job with the split pushing, but the Tigers not reacting well to the split push comps coming in tonight and overplaying their hand, not respecting the split push Rek'Sai. Samsung played it well, but they did have a very weak composition in the late game for those team fights.
Yeah, much weaker than they did in game one. They still almost made it work, but it looks like that Bard may be put on the shelf regardless for game three. Try to maybe bring something else out that they've prepared on the side of Samsung if they want to change the tempo of the game a little bit against the Ku Tigers.
Yeah, well, that was an exciting game. The Ku Tigers used to be so clean. We didn't used to see them make these mistakes.